Lu Kong Hao Hu Wa CAAL Lo Shi Yo Coalition of Asian American Leaders Yo Yi Ba Community Leaders Ta Mo Ke Cha Seng Cha Racial Equity Nyo Ta Hao Che Gan Da Seng Po CAAL Te Li Cha Ta Jo Tha Jo Wa Hao Lu Nyo Ta Hao Seng Po Public School Te An Ta Ta Jo School Board To Jao Shi Tha Shi Bao Ji Yi Cha Ta Cha Ke Gan Da Jong Tia Ke Ba Shi Zao Ta Jo Mi Nyo Wa Yo Lan Da Papa Ning Cha Feng Chong Che Yo Jo Mi Nyo Mong Yin Vi Hai Tia Nyo Ta Hao Seng Po Public School Jo Mi Nyo Mong Yin Yo Jo Chong Duo Le Hai Ning Tan Cha Lo Tia Ta Ta Chi Yi Wa Ke Hai Tia Yo Wa Li Cha Kho E Seng Po Public School Te Li Yo Mo Ke Ba Zao Ta Jo Mi Nyo Gan Da Go Chong Duo Ku The your college ya the li mo mong mo wa hau lu gan tao duo nya to hau che gan tao ni no mong yin mo cho gan tao xia tia mo cho zhen je yo lo ba cho tun cai gan tao ge zhong tie yo ba ge mo ke shi ta tao de cho nie cho xi chi ta li su nya to lu shi hao ta shi no chi mo tu superintendent Nyo to ho che gan da Saint Paul Public School e ya che gan da ta to thia I tu chia no che sha ro sa ko che gan da yo chun thia ko tao tu superintendent o nu to tao cha mong jong
Like the school district is because you're not embracing the culture and linguistic assets that we bring to the school district. So what can you do more to help us think about that? And we already have the curriculums. It's not like you have to rebuild any of it. We have the language competency in our communities already. So it's all there for you. How will you include us? And at the end, it's about relationship. Relationship is extremely important. And we want to build that relationship with you. We want you to come into our community and to initiate those kinds of relationship. And at the end, it's about the students, right? That's what we're talking about. And why aren't we including them? Why are they not participating? What can we do more? And I think that this is very important for you to hear. And for me too, in the many years that I've lived in Minnesota, this is the first time that I ever seen so many Asians in one room really being honest about how they feel. And not only because they're parents, but they actually work for you in the district and they feel left out and invisible. So what can we do to change that?
As we all know, the majority of St. Paul Public Schools Asian students are Hmong and Korean. And as they enter college, they are well aware of their disadvantage, especially at a predominantly white institution. The majority also come from low-income family. Many of them see financial barriers and family needs. It becomes a priority for them instead of their education. They are also not equipped with the support and skills they need to become, which then to help them navigate within the college system. As you can see, when we looked at the ACT scores for Asian, overall on the nationwide, it's pretty high, but within our St. Paul Public School District, it's sitting at 18. And from my experience within these statistics, many of our students that it's very true that many of our students that graduate from the high schools are not prepared for college.
If I'm thinking about sending my child to a school in the St. Paul Promise neighborhood, he will be in relationship and he will be going to school with young people who are facing intense poverty, intense homelessness, right, intense violence, and that these young folks continuously demand us to actually think about STOP, right? And not think about test scores and not think about MCA, but to actually think about what we're gonna do together to solve these real world problems. This is what my son, this is what I'm anticipating my son coming into. My hope is that we can stop, right? And not think about MCAs, but really, if we're really concerned with developing the next young generation of, you know, community members that are actually gonna regenerate community and that will eventually build that strong Minnesota economy, that we're thinking about what the issues that our young people constantly are demanding us to think about in the classrooms as they show up.
Because I work with parents, you know, day to day, and they always ask me when the school district going to accommodate or implement language and culture classes for Korean, because our population earlier it was show only 3,000, but then I believe that 3,000 is like the official, you know, first migration, but we have majority who came here as a second, third migrator who came from other states, and our population is now grown to like 10,000 plus in St. Paul areas alone. So our population grown rapidly, and our student population has grown to, I believe now, you know, I would say a good 3,000 students, current students in the district as well. But then parents ask, when are you going to accommodate? When the district going to accommodate? At least, you know, start something so that our kids can maintain and can appreciate our own language, because at home, many students, many kids, they don't like to speak their language anymore. They thought that their language are being devalued or, you know, not appreciated, and they feel shy, they feel that they don't want to speak the language anymore. And we know that, you know, when the kid don't speak the language that they know, it did not really help them much either to learn English language. So
I want to challenge you to seek out and look for teachers that look like our kids. I cannot emphasize how important that is. I want to challenge you to look for opportunities for parent, and because you will find, it's true, parents might, it's hard to get parents involved. I know schools work hard to involve parents, but find the parents that will. But our kids need to see role models that are doing well. When you have a speaker, have a Hmong speaker, have a Karen speaker, have an Indian speaker, come in and have that child feel, there are plenty of times when they feel like they're down there. So make the opportunities for them to feel like they are up there, like they're that those positive role models are there. The other piece that you said, Sayun, again, I cannot agree more, college readiness. I think that's such an important piece to encourage our children, to really all our children, so, you know, all kids across the board, to feel like they can dream and be able to achieve those dreams. And I feel we lack terribly in terms of preparing our kids for college and for preparing our kids for higher education, for thinking big, for thinking broad, for thinking about where they could go. You know, we don't give them enough credit for what they are able to.